Howdy, I'm RK, and this is Game Endeavor. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to use cutouts to make great-looking animations for your Godot games. We'll be making a run cycle like the one you see here. Cutout animations are useful because they're easy to make since you don't have to draw each individual frame of the animation. They look great because you're using tweening to move the pieces around, which has a very pleasing and modern aesthetic. Let's go ahead and get started. For this tutorial, I'll be using a cute little teddy bear. Say hello to Paul Bearer. I like to keep my character cutouts simple because I enjoy the style, plus it allows for a lot of flexibility when creating my animations. And I'll be simplifying this even further by keeping all the major pieces together, but you could separate your facial features, ears, and even joints to animate to your heart's content. I'm going to create the rig as its own node so that I can inherit from it later if I want to make changes to it, such as changing the sprites for similar characters of the same style. I'll go ahead and create all the sprites for the cutouts that I'm going to be using. The torso is going to be the main part of the rig, so everything will be parented to it. Whenever I move the torso, the entire body will move with it. You will want to do this further down if your cutout is more complex, such as parenting facial features to the head. I'll also be creating nodes for the head, both of the arms, and both of the legs, toggling Show Behind Parent for the left arm and leg. This can be found in the visibility list of the canvas item properties. This is better than using layers because if you have multiple rigs in the same scene, then you could see bits and pieces passing through each other. I will also be using a sprite atlas, so I will need to enable region and set the rect values. And right quick, I'll know that Godot has a bone system if you would like to use it. It comes with kinematic rigging, which is likely to be handy if you're dealing with more complex cutouts. There's a link in the description to documentation of how you can implement this. Personally, I find it a little clumsy to use, preferring instead to work within the inspector, using the grab and rotate mode to adjust the nodes. These can be selected in the toolbar in the top left, or more conveniently with the W and E keys respectively. Using these modes, I never need to lock my node, because if I have it selected in the scene tree, then it keeps it locked to my selection. To avoid tangents and to give your character a bit of depth, you'll want to place their furthest leg a little higher up than their closest leg. You may also want to make sure that you can see their left arm in the neutral position. So I like to rotate their left arm a bit so that it pokes out from behind them. And one last note, just because we're using cutout animation doesn't mean we're stuck with using just these cutouts. You can use the animation player to change the sprites, which will open up a lot of possibilities in your animations. If you're using a sprite sheet, then you can change the rect for the region, but you'll need to change the type of the interpolation to discrete so that it'll immediately change rather than tweening across the sprite sheet, which you probably don't want. With my sprites set up how I want them for the idle animation, one thing I like to do is to temporarily create a square in the scene to align the resting position by making sure that the top of the head and the bottom of the feet are roughly the same distance from each other. Once that is done, I'll delete the shape. I'll go ahead and add an animation player to the root node. Then make a new animation state called idle and add keyframes for the position and rotation. If you select all of the nodes in the scene, then you can click the key in the toolbar up here and it will automatically create tracks and frames for the nodes based on the properties selected to the left of the key. Now we'll go ahead and get started on a simple running animation. This will be very similar to the 3-frame run animations you will find in retro games, except we'll be using tweens to achieve it. The first frame will be the idle position, so we can go ahead and store our current settings again. This is known as the down position in a run cycle. It is the point where the character is closest to the ground. We will need to set this pose 3 times for this animation, so to make this easier for ourselves, we'll go ahead and do this now. The duration of the cycle will be 0.8 seconds, so go ahead and set that. For now, we'll be working in 0.2 second steps, so you can adjust that if you want to make it a little easier for yourself. And then rekey our pose at the time 0.4 and 0.8 seconds. For the other keyframes, we're going to rotate our arms and legs to their extreme positions. We'll do the first one at time 0.2 seconds. Make sure that your arms and legs of the same side are rotating opposite of each other. When doing these animations, depending on the style of your game, you'll likely want to exaggerate, so make sure there is plenty of motion, otherwise your animation can end up looking stiff and unappealing. However, just rotating the arms and legs will make the animation look mechanical. Whenever we run, we also sway our hips and shoulders. To convey this, I will be adjusting the position of the arms and legs accordingly. And finally, for the last frame, we'll do exactly what we did for the second frame, except in the opposite direction at 0.6 seconds. Since I use a 3/4 turn for my animations, it wouldn't look right to move the legs and arms exactly the way we did for the other frame, so there may need to be some variance. For example, you'll notice that on this frame I am able to spread the legs more, mostly because I can bring the right leg further back than the left leg could have went. But this is a good thing, as it adds some variation and interest to the animation. And although you can't see the left arm when it's behind the character, you should still try to get the motion as accurately as you can, because it will affect the tweening motion of the animation as it passes behind it. And that is the bare minimum for a run cycle, but as you can probably tell, it feels a little mechanical, unpolished, and not very pleasant to look at. there are a few tweaks we can do to really bring this to life. For starters, as we move our character, we're just sliding it along the ground. However, in reality when we run, we bounce up and down. So if we add a little up motion to the aptly named up frames, where the limbs are at their most extreme, then our run animation will have a lot more bounce to it. Also, motion isn't as linear as it is in the animation player by default. Whenever you move, your limbs have acceleration and deceleration. Without this, the motion looks very mechanical. We can fix this by adjusting the easing, which can be changed in the edit panel. The default in-out easings are way too much and make the animation look comically snappy. This may vary based on what you're doing, but for my purposes, I generally set a value between negative 1.25 and negative 1.5. And if you offset the arms, having them lead before the legs, then you will make the animation feel more enthusiastic and appealing. I will decrease the step size to 0.1 to have a small offset. I will select all of the keys for the arm tracks and shift them one step to the right. And with that done, I can set the track position to the end of the animation, which is now empty, and key in a new frame. I will then move to the start of the animation, then select the keys I just added and duplicate them. And that should do it for this run cycle. Over the past weekend, I participated in a game jam. There's a link in the description below if you would like to check it out. I made an asteroid defense game where you must defend Earth using a planetary rail cannon defense system. Thank you for watching and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then join the sub club and let me know what you thought. And be sure to come back next week for another video. There are also links to my Twitter and Discord in the description if you're interested. I would love to hear from you, whether it be feedback, suggestions, or topics you would like for me to cover in the future. And until next time, y'all take it easy.